ladies and gentlemen. I'm Meadsy69. Welcome back to the channel and another episode of Band. Now, this one here, you can see this endurance just slightly pushing. I mean, he does push our guy here. Only for a split second. It was only for a split second, but sometimes it doesn't matter how often you do it. And you can see that they are just saying, like, you know, you're useless. You're absolutely useless. And the argument actually does continue on. One of the guys, now the endurance is, they're both in a platoon. So there's two of them. And one of them tries to defend and say, you'll see the defending in a moment. But as I've said, it doesn't matter if you push someone out in the open for a split second or if you push someone out in the open all battle. At the end of the day, if you push someone out in the open just because you want them to get shot rather than you, or you want them to die rather than you, then that is, in my opinion, a bannable offence. You shouldn't do it. You should not be pushing anybody out in the open. And you can see here, you know, the Senlac is reported endurance. And of course, this is where they're going to start hitting back, saying, what, for trying to cap? No, it's got nothing to do with you trying to cap. And this frisky tank here is, I mean, look, for blocking. And then he tries putting the blame, like, you were in front. You were blocking him. No, that isn't the case. That is not the case whatsoever. And then when the perky tank here said, I mean, look, you can't get blocked from behind. Yes, you can when you're trying to get out the way. And then the other guy just before the here, look, you push me out. And then the other guy was just like, yeah, because you're a pussy. So, yeah, there we go. Yeah, because you're a pussy. So his friend's trying to defend him. And then he just turns out saying, yeah, I did, because you're a pussy. So I still think it needs to be banned. I mean, something like that, maybe not a permaban, but it still needs to have a look at, and it still needs to be banned. Moving on to the next game. Now this one, straight at the start, you've got my favorite tank here, the XM, and then you've got the TVP, look, just turning around, and then like, yeah, no, you're not gonna play. I'm just gonna sit here and block you right at the start of the game. One of the best mediums in the game, and he decides to block one of the best tanks in the game for no reason. Nothing was said at all. The game just started. He turned around and decided he wanted to block this guy, and it needs to be, again, things like this should be permabanned. Now there are, I mean, look, you like that shit? I mean, what is that all about? What do you mean you like that shit? Why would he like that shit? He's trying to play a game. Everyone else is trying to play a game. And then you're ruining it just by sitting in front. And then I think he just sits there. And our guy is just like, okay, let's go. And it's like nothing ever happened. He's going to get on with his game. And that's basically it. What was the point of it? You know, what was the point? Because at the end of the day, the TVP and the XM could have been in this position already. They could have been getting damage already. And then the TVP decides, you know what, let's just go this side of the map. Again, he does sit behind. I didn't see anything too bad there. I don't think he was trying to push him. Well, no, he's trying to hide behind him. And that is the difference. You know, there is a difference between hiding behind a tank and pushing a tank out. I hide behind tanks all the time. You know, there's nothing wrong with using a tank in front as armor as long as you're not in the way if they are trying to get out of the way. I mean, the T-62 is not happy. He really is not happy there, calling him a C-U-N-T. He really, really is not happy. But as I've said, there is a difference. And I do hide behind tanks all the time if there's tanks in front of me. And I also, you know, people do it to me, but it's very frustrating when you're in the line of fire, you're trying to reverse, and someone's right there. They're not intentionally trying to block you, but they're just there because they're using you as a bit of cover. It's annoying, but I do understand that, and that is a little bit different than blocking someone. So moving on to the final game. Now, this one is a little bit funny because, I mean, I know our guy in the Emil one, he has a bad game. And I'm not going to sit there and say he didn't, because he does stuff. I'm literally watching this replay thinking, what are you doing, dude? Honestly, what are you doing? But ultimately, we're going to look at the Centurion 1. Now, the Centurion 1 at the moment has gone sort of, he's up in the middle there. Nothing too wrong, you know. There's no rule about positioning or anything like that, which we've seen on this map before. Yes, you know, I may add these kind of people in World of Dummies, not for ban, but just for being dummies, because there's certain positions you should be in, and there's certain positions that you shouldn't be. Now, our guy in the Emil, I mean, he's just come around this corner and opened up pretty much everybody. Well, there's four tanks there. So he does now do the right thing in backing up and getting out of the way. Now, the Centurion is still running around doing absolutely nothing. And you can see him going to be hiding. He's pushing the red line, and then he is heading toward the corner. So the Emil here, again, he is still trying. He's managed to bounce 1,000 damage. He's got 1,200 damage. But some things he starts to do now, I'm like, dude, what are you doing? There's like four or five tanks around that corner. What in the world are you doing? The Centurion has now got into position, and he's actually pushing the J Panther out here. Now, I am going to sort of fast forward it in a minute, because it does get quite funny. So, you know, there's a couple of tanks there. So the Yo there is now down to a one shot. So he's going to try and get the shot, can't quite get the shot. So he's going to go out, and then there is the Glacial there. So unfortunately can't quite get the shot. So he's now losing a lot of hit points. He's only on 850 hit points. That there was a bad shot, I do admit, but he's backing up, which again is the right thing. He doesn't have hit points, and really what he needs to do with the tanks in front of him, because they're all low hit points, he has to reload all three shells. He has to, you know, without a doubt. That was a bit of a mistake there against the Annihilator, because now he's a one shot to some of these tanks. He's got the three shells loaded. It's not an auto reloader, it's actually an auto loader. So he's got three shells loaded, and then he can start pushing out. But considering there's three tanks or four tanks around there, he's still pushing. I mean, even now, look, 37 hit points, he's still trying to push forward and go around the corner. So a little bit of a mistake there from the Emil, and then we get to this guy right here. Okay, again, he's in a position, I'm not gonna complain too much, until he starts again pushing the J Panther out of position. Now, at the moment, I mean, the enemy have got two bases. The green team are not even interested. They're not even interested in capping any bases. So because the Centurion was pushing the J-Panther, he's going to seize his opportunity and think, right, do you know what? I'm going to go for it. And he starts pushing him. Does it make it right? Of course, it's not right for the J-Panther to do that. Does it make it understandable? Of course, it is understandable. The Centurion was pushing the J-Panther. The J-Panther managed to get away, and then the J-Panther is now seizing his opportunity to do the same to the Centurion. Now, two rights don't make a wrong. I get that, and if you're going to ban one, you're probably going to have to ban two. But, you know, even now, look, no one is interested in capping any bases. So four tanks left. There's still a lot of hit points on the green team. Not so much on the red team, but yet they lose on supremacy points. And it doesn't help with people like the Centurion, who was full hit points, doing absolutely nothing instead of trying to just block people. And as you can see there, he does absolutely nothing. So ban these people, Wargaming. Hope you enjoyed today's video. I'm Meadsy69, and I'll catch you all soon. Bye-bye.